Good morning. This is Al Koritz. I'm Applications and Service Manager at Electron Microscopy Sciences. Today we're sitting in front of a Q150 VES Plus coating system. And I am going to give you an overview of the menu selections and what you would need to know to set up for different processes. This is the same across all the Plus systems. The display is an interface is different from the earlier systems prior to September of 2018. This is what you see when you turn the system on and it goes through its boot process. I've already logged in as an agent, which gives me access to far more than the average user is allowed. So let's go through the different options as we see it here on the display. So first, let's look at history. History is essentially a process log. It shows you what the system has been doing. You select a process. You can look at how the system is set up for that particular process, and you can view any messages or such for a particular process. Now, this one was rather boring. It will save, I think, up to 100 or more. So here is a controlled pulse cord process from a previous application I did. It gives you the system status, the process time in seconds, demand current, lots and lots of information. Again, you can look at an overview of what was programmed in. The nice thing about the Plus series is these process history logs can be easily exported to a thumb drive and used on your computer. We'll look at login next. So if you want to change user, you have to put a password in, as well as a username. These are installed by the system administrator. There may be a default password in system that your local manager will set up and allow you access to different parts of the system. We'll do materials next. There is a complete materials library that the system is capable of running these processes. For instance, here's aluminum. Press the down arrow. It shows you the process parameters. If you wish to change those parameters, depending on your access level granted by your user ID, you can tap on that box and change that information so you can operate with the best possible process parameters. And it's this way for all the materials that are installed in the system. Over here we have the systems menu. I won't go into too much, but this allows you to set the date and time, so we'll ignore that. We have file manager, and under file manager we have backup, where you can back up all your process parameters and profiles to a thumb drive. There's a restore button. If for some reason the operating files get corrupted, you can restore them. You can do a software update that's provided by generally myself if it becomes available and there are any software glitches to repair or fix. You can download the files from an email I send you and upload them to the system so you have the current software installed. Then we have file manager. So these are all the different files in the system for all the different systems. It allows you to export them, to move them around. No real rocket science there. We have the About menu, which tells you the software versions installed. Generally, if we're talking on the phone because you have an issue, sometimes I'll ask you to take a cell phone photo of the About page so I know what the software level is installed. Gives you the FTM status. This system has one channel FTMs. The Q300 series have two. Tells you how much of the crystal is used and what the current crystal frequency is. Maintenance. The maintenance menu is just a series of reminders and milestones when things happen. Like, for instance, when I'm done with this video, I'm going to clean the chamber, so I will press reset, which will store today's date and time that the chamber was cleaned, the system was serviced by a service person, processing done since last clean, 40 minutes, operational time zero. Don't know why that's zero, but it is. Users. Users allows you to install a particular password or user and what levels they're able to access in the system menus. This is all explained in some detail in the manual. We won't go into it. This is just sort of an overview. Properties. This is the basic process parameters for the system. Some of these that are grayed out are not able to be changed under this password level that I'm in there. Everything in black. Can be changed by just tapping on it, and you can either scroll back and forth. It tells you down here I'm on page 3, now I'm on page 2, or you can just tap the button and you can get to the menu that you desire. Network. Network will allow you to put your tool online where I can access it via remote connection. It's a good idea in theory. However, with companies with elaborate firewalls to keep bad actors out of your system, many times they won't allow this connection. It's here if it needs to be used, but for the most part, it's a non-player in the scheme of things. Clear log files allows you to clear all the process logs. We won't do that today. There's the home button, which brings you back to the home. Now, these are all the user and default processes or recipes that are installed. Each one does a different function. If you want to vent the chamber, you want to run the stage, you want to store the system after use under vacuum, you would use vacuum shutdown. There's a number of processes that are already installed. This is the process parameters that I currently have for a platinum coating. And again, you can scroll back and forth. Bleed vacuum you can't change on this menu. Back to recipes, there's a number of them. If you want to add one, you hit this little symbol down here, and that will allow you to add a new process. At any time, you can press the I button and it will give you the help menu where you can pull up a cheat sheet on how to do something. This is just the little vacuum gauge bar that you can pull up if you want it. This is the symbol for adding users. And of course, that's the home button. So this is a very simple overview. If you need more detailed information, I suggest you read the manual to find the areas that you need additional information from. It's quite simple, quite intuitive, very easy to work with. Thanks very much. Good day.